All right, so hello everyone. We'll discuss about G.H. Clark Clinical Repository today. And those who know me personally, they know that I'm really fond of repositories and homeopathic software very much. And along with Phatak Repository, along with Borix Repository, this G.H. Clark Repository is very, very useful in treating certain acutes and some chronic cases as well. And you this type of repository, you may not able to make the totality of the symptom each and every time, but there are certain PQRS rubrics in this repository you will able to find out, which can able to differentiate and distinguish your case pretty well. Beautiful repository to have. So we'll start learning about it. And if you know the biography, G.H. Clark was born in 1853. He was more eminent homeopath of England, so he was from England. He devoted his life for the advancement of homeopathy. He is a keen follower of Campton Burnet. So James Campton Burnet, he was the follower of it, who himself was in direct hierarchy of Rudolph, who was the prominent homeopath at that time. So Campton Burnet edited his last volume of Homeopathic World, and the next month in May 1885, Dr. Clark commenced as the editor. So this was the magazine at that time. This was a premium magazine at that time, the Homeopathic World. So they also had a group, J.H. Clark, Robert T. Cooper, and James Campton Burnet together formed the Cooper's Club. They are the group. A regular meeting at the British Homeopath was the source of many symptoms in the Clark's Dictionary of Materia Medica. So they had a beautiful group. We call it as Cooper's Club. And this is all about the works of James Campton Burnet. The major is the Dictionary of Materia Medica, 3 volumes, which are very, very useful. And it's a very vast and broad Materia Medica. You can also pause it down this video and you can look around all this work. Okay, so the repository, the clinical repository of Clark, was based on directly on the Dictionary of Materia Medica, which was also written by the same author. And you can see there are majorly the 3 chapters. The plan of construction remains the same. There are 3 basic chapters. One is clinical, second is causation, and third is temperament and disposition. Especially this clinical and causation chapter of this repository is very useful. I found some beautiful cases being cured from these 2 chapters. Especially temperament can be also used sometimes somewhere, but this clinical and causation. In acute, if you find some beautiful causation from the class repository, single medicine rubric, the result may get enhanced terrifically well. So some of the gem of Borix repository, I would say, and we will discuss about it. And that's the only way you can learn the repository. It may be not each and every time possible to try to make the totality from this 3 repertory, Phatak, Borix, and Clark. But you can club out the PQRS symptom and you can learn it from it. So, clinical in chapter, diabetes insipidus in children. Think of Creticus. How many of you thought of Creticus as a remedy? Creticus in lower potency in mother tincture, it acts beautifully well, not only in heart complaint but in diabetes insipidus as well. Catalepsy, menses suppurate with menses suppurate, if you find something very catalepsy type of condition, seizure type of condition, think of this remedy, veratrum album. How many of you thought of veratrum album as a remedy? And this is an interesting rubric. Gums in the boil. Boil in the gum. That's the Merck and Senecula is the remedy. How many of you thought of Senecula as a remedy? Think of this. And if you can see the temperaments as well. Alcohol drunk care after leaving. So after leaving alcohol, there are certain symptoms. Think of calcarea ars as a remedy. Very unknown remedy for this type of complaints. How many of you thought of bronchitis in old persons? Think of hypogyginum as a remedy. It's a no sword. Prefer from the ox, I think cow's gallbladder. Think of this remedy. And this remedy especially, you know, has been used very frequent by one of my friend in COVID cases as well. It's a good spear of action in respiratory system as well. Temperament, children who take readily when weather changes. So whenever someone a children टेक द कोल्ड इजली एंड रेडली व्हेन द वेदर द वेदर चेंजेस थिंक ऑफ सीपी एज अ रेमेडी. एंड नाउ इन द कॉजेशन सेक्शन विच इज द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट वुंड क्लीन कट सिंगल रेमेडी स्टेफिसैग्रिया wound dissecting think of pyrogenum often we used to think whenever there will be pus we think give pyrogenum or anthraxinum but in dissecting wound as well think of pyrogenum wound lacerated think of calendula anger effect of cough there is lots of anger which is the effect of cough which is causing the F cough think of antimtar and aurum metallicum indignation which is the cause of indignation think of colocynth causation is scolding this could be a case of certain child after getting scolding in the school he developed the disease from fever think of tarantula causation punishment think of tarantula my dear friends So beautiful repertory, and I hope you all can use this in acutes as well. You may get some beautiful result getting from this particular remedy repertory. And these are our two books. You can also have this. Do write it down to me at nishant25smilebox@gmail.com, and don't forget to our channel.